back here at the Ferguson Showroom. I am with Chef Anthony Phillips, and we've brought Walden in to help us with the cooking so that you and I can chat some more. Okay, so why don't we get started? What's the first step?
Okay, first thing we're gonna do is we got our pans nice and hot, and that's always the best thing with sauteing. You always want your pan hot. So what Walden's gonna do now is he's gonna split up the oil into two pans.
I have never seen a pan this big.
Well, one thing with kale is that it's such a fluffy vegetable that you kind of need a big pan. If you try to do a small one, you won't get an evenly cooked. So, So what he's gonna do now is he's gonna put the fennel in there. He's gonna put the dusted fennel on the ahi. Just put it right on. There you go. And then he's gonna season it with a little salt. Make sure it's all rolled nice.
That looks great. Mm-hmm. And again, the dish we're making today is a dish on your new menu.
Yes.
Right.
And I designed it to be fast because we do so much people that come in, like we really want to have the guests have their meal as quick as possible.
Yeah, we appreciate that.
Yeah.
Thank you. Again, it's the North Shore Kula Grill, and it's at the Turtle Bay Resort. If you haven't been out there, there's been a lot of changes, a lot of improvements.
Yeah, they renovated all of our rooms 2 years ago. Everything looks really nice. They've done a lot to our lawn care. We're actually opening a brunch on Saturday and Sunday. We have a late night at Kula Grill as well with a lot of local talent that play music there. A lot of things have been changing in a good way.
Okay, good. Now, you guys have a sister restaurant that also has a new menu, is that right?
Yes, it's going to be launching in the next month, and it's Pa'akai, which is means salt. So it's a lot of seafood, and it's run by Chef John Armstrong. And he basically came up with this new menu, and it's really nice, and we're super excited to get it on.
Yay. Well, one thing great about these restaurants, too, is there's really a focus to use local products, you know, local seafood.
Well, one big thing now is a lot of people are getting their ahi away from Hawaii, so we try to make it a point to get all of our local seafood. So that's one thing we're really proud about.
Good.
So.
And I noticed you guys are cooking with gas. Is that what you guys use?
Yes, gas is the best way. It's the best way to evenly heat up your pans. Compared to electric, you can't really get that good temperature that you need.
Yeah.
Gas is the best way to go in the kitchen.
Yeah.
Okay, so first he's going to saute his hamako mushrooms. And he's going to get a nice little color on that one. And it's a real nice dish. Like fennel, it gives a nice licorice smell to it. So it's got a real aromatic to it.
Oh, I can smell it. As soon as you said licorice, I'm like, oh, you're up.
And it kind of reminds you of like pho because they use the anise in it. It's almost the same thing, so.
Okay.
And then he's going to add his kale in. And what I tell my cooks all the time is I like to hear that crisp as soon as it hits the pan.
Yeah. I heard it. Well, kale, everybody loves kale. It's a superfood, right? Everybody's talking about.
And you know, in the new menu, I tried to make kale as one of the featured things, and also quinoa. Like, we do a quinoa fried rice at Kula Grill. It's really nice.
I love that. It sounds like there's a lot of healthier options on the menu.
Well, people are getting conscious about what they're eating now, so.
As they should be, right?
So what he's going to do is he's going to toss it a couple times, and then he's going to hit it with a little bit of salt and white wine. And we don't want to overcook the kale because we want it to be really fluffy on the plate.
Okay. This looks great. So you guys are open for breakfast and dinner.
Breakfast and dinner.
Okay.
We open at 5:30 at night and 6 o'clock in the morning.
Okay, great. That looks so good. It's a nice, vibrant color, too.
It's just, there's nothing wrong with good, healthy food.
Yeah.
A lot of people are scared. They run away from it. So,
you know why? I know even for me, I'm not a good cook, right? So when I try to eat healthy, it's very bland.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not like that at the restaurants. When you guys do it, it tastes great.
Well, see, this is real simple. Just a little white wine and salt, it totally transforms the taste of the kale.
Okay. Great. That sounds good. So in our next segment, we'll go ahead and plate it and give it a try.
Okay.
Sounds good?
All right.
Thank you so much.
Wow, look at that, Trini. It's like you said, the kale when they put it in, but then it cooks down like that. That's so cool.
Mm-hmm.
Look at that piece of fish.
Mm-hmm.
And you were saying that licorice smell, really that kind of smell came across?
Yes.
Wow.
I'm sorry, I'm watching that going, I remember that dish. Yum.
Yeah.